Welcome to Community Concerts at Second's 35th season of world-class music, offered free to all. Serving our hometown of Baltimore and the wider region through live and virtual events, the series is presented at Second Presbyterian Church and was founded by Margaret Budd in 1987. Community Concerts at Second is an independent, nonprofit organization, and our mission is to enrich our community by providing free professional musical experiences of lasting artistic value. Today's concert is made possible by you, our audience, and our donors. Since we do not charge admission to our concerts, we rely upon contributions from you, our audience. Please consider making a contribution to the concert series online at cc2nd.org or by texting cc2 to the number 44321. We thank you for your attention and your support, and we hope you enjoy today's concert.
Fancy. Hi, Amy. I'm so happy to see all of you here this evening. I've been asked to say a couple words just to tell you what this piece is about. It was written initially for full orchestra, a very large orchestra, actually, and this arrangement was made, and it's pretty delightful. We all play everybody else's parts, so, you know, there's a part where Austin's playing something that Harrison had when we played it with orchestra, so there's a lot of flexibility in here. This piece is about a folklore guy named Till Eulenspiegel, and he was a prankster, and he, you know, you can hear the horses running and knocking carts over and him getting into all kinds of trouble, flirting with girls he shouldn't be flirting with, and, you know, he had no taste. And so he got in big trouble for blasphemy and was sentenced to death. So at the end, you can hear actually his head getting chopped off in the funeral march. And so that's pretty fun. But yeah, so we start out with Once Upon a Time. That's me. And then we hear Till in the horn and his pranks. We hear from Vitor over there. So enjoy. I'm excited to play for you. We all are.
Thank you. Good evening. Good evening and welcome to everyone in our live audience and to all who are watching us online. My name is Melusina Morris, and I'm the president of the Community Concerts at Seconds Governing Board. Many thanks to the incredible musicians from the Baltimore Symphony Orchestra who opened tonight's concert with that wonderful, playful Till Eulenspiegel. Bravo. We are so happy that all of you have joined us for another world-class performance at Second, free to all in this community. Our series would not exist without you, our audience members and generous donors. If you have already made a gift to the series this season, we deeply appreciate your generosity and thank you very much for your support. But if you have not made a gift yet, please consider making a cash donation tonight, making an online contribution at our website, or by using our text to give portal. You can find details on how to do that with signs in our lobby. I should take a moment to recognize the incredible partner we have in presenting our concerts free of charge. It is the congregation here at Second Presbyterian Church. Thank you, Second Presbyterian, for this acoustically perfect space. We have been enjoying this space with our terrific partner for 35 years in our music making. Now I am very pleased to note that tonight is a very special moment in our season. As you all look at your program, you may notice by the next selection on the concert, there's a little star by the title. That means this is a world premiere, and that we are all about to join together in listening to music that no other audience on Earth, or any other planet, has heard. This sonata for solo cello was commissioned and will be performed by Dariusz Skoraczewski, the principal cellist of the Baltimore Symphony, and the composer of this music is James Lee III. Dr. Lee is one of the most acclaimed and sought after composers in this country. His works have been commissioned and performed by the National Symphony, Baltimore Symphony, the Philadelphia Orchestra, Detroit Symphony, Memphis Symphony, Indianapolis Symphony, the St. Louis Symphony, the Rich Chamber Players, and many other organizations and individuals. Born in Michigan, Dr. Lee earned a doctorate from the University of Michigan and was a composition fellow at the Tanglewood Music Center. Now a resident of Baltimore, he is a professor of composition at Morgan State University and a wonderful treasure of this musical community. We are very fortunate to have James Lee here with us tonight. So, since we do not have a printed set of program notes to enlighten us about this new composition, I would like to ask James and Dariusz both to join me on stage to share a few words about this sonata. James and Dariusz. Question number one, Dariusz, could you briefly tell us how you decided to commission this work and what were you seeking from James in this new solo work?
Yes, we have to share.
Yes. Well, thank you, and thank you very much for having me here tonight. How did it come about? I think it started, well, years ago probably, when I first played one of your quartets, I believe, Quintet or so. And then last summer, I played Abraham Sanz, which is also a solo cello piece that you wrote, that James wrote, and I really loved it. And I approached him about commissioning a piece for a solo cello. And luckily, my student, Fred Garris, I'm not sure if you're here, but he really helped me. I mean, he completely helped me with the commission. So I was very fortunate to make that happen, and here we are.
Thank you. James, welcome to Community Concerts at Second. Please tell us a little about the process for writing this three-movement sonata Did you and Dariusz collaborate frequently during this creative process?
Well, it's good to be here this evening. I listen to a lot of music and a lot of orchestral music, and especially with cello. I've loved cello. I've been wanting to write a cello concerto for a long time, and a sonata for cello and piano, or a cello solo. And I've been doing mostly thinking about cello solo because I'm a pianist also, and if I wrote for piano, then there's a temptation where I might play it. And I'm thinking there's probably a lot more other pianists that can play it better than me. But I wanted to really explore this solo piece, and then there was a collaboration, because as a pianist, I'm not a cellist, even though I'm familiar with writing for cello. We had a collaboration of just recently, just, you know, tweaking some passages and thinking about how something might be more idiomatic for the cello, some the way to speak certain musical ideas are more idiomatic in the cello. So there was it was great help in that collaboration.
Great, thank you. And finally, and this is for both of you, what should we listen for in this piece? Are there certain techniques that you used or expressive moments that you really don't want us to miss as you're performing? Where should we, who would like to speak?
Well, in this, I love to really work with the different ranges of an instrument. So at certain points, we all know the cello can play this nice, beautiful resonant, these resonant low notes. And then I always try to make certain elements almost sound strained. So that's one part, because when it really gets passionate, like in the second movement, even parts of the first movement, but especially in the second movement, some of these high notes, just like in Abraham's Son, the kind of that deep feeling, that deep emotional striving is what something I like to really point out in the piece. And then certain aspects of dealing with the way the cello was actually played in terms of articulations, that kind of thing. And then there are some harmonics and things, you know, some of the things you might expect for a string instrument, but some of those really passionate contrasts I would like to highlight. And then the last movement, there are some compound melodies that are happening also.
Dariusz, anything you don't want us to miss?
No, just enjoy the piece. It's a fantastic piece, and I'm really happy for you to be here watching this, because just imagine if you were somewhere hundreds of years ago and watched first performance of a Brahms symphony or Beethoven's Fifth Symphony. Just imagine that. So this is something like that, exactly, 100%. So please enjoy.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Appreciate it.
Thank you. Thank you. Yin. We're playing a work by Chinese-born American composer Fang Man
called Larkspur that she composed in 2004 and revised in 2006. And she has a program note she's provided, which I will read. Larkspur represents a flower as well as a color. Fickleness, ardent attachment, levity and lightness have been indicated to describe this word. Larkspur is the birth flower for July, and it symbolizes an open heart and passion. And you'll hear throughout the piece that Fang Man writes in a very modern language, but there are many influences to this piece. We particularly heard the music of Sofia Gubadolina, Claude Debussy, and Toru Takemitsu, all of who also wrote trios for this particular instrument combination. And I think much of this piece has a contemplative feel, but there are a lot of gestures traded throughout the instruments, and you'll hear in the middle there's a big climactic section. This has quite a frenetic feel, a big contrast to the rest of the piece. And there are many extended techniques in it, especially in the harp, which gets to play quite an aggressive role. So we hope you enjoy Larkspur.
Thank you. Thank you. Hi again. So the next one we're doing, as I only do quintets that have bass in them. No. The next one we're doing is, actually it was very unfamiliar to me when we started it. It's not as well known, but not because it's not super fun. It's Prokofiev wrote this actually for ballerinas. So it was part of a ballet. So every movement is, you know, written with some theme in mind. It's also based on a circus. And so is it the second movement? The second movement starts off with the bear, which you can see in this tiny lady right there. And you know, we have a bunch of theories about what each movement is, but I encourage you to use your imagination and figure out what each movement inspires you to think of circus. And I think that's all I have. So enjoy, it's a fun one. It's I think 6 movements and it's good. All right, have fun.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you all for joining us here today for our 2021-2022 season of live and digitally streamed concerts. Please remember that we do not charge admission for any of our events, which are made possible by donations from you, our audience. Please consider making a contribution to the series online at cc2nd.org or by texting cc2 to the number 44321. We appreciate your support in helping us to provide world-class music free to all members of the Baltimore community and beyond.